The discussions around mobile lending apps and their overall benefit to the Kenya economy has been a subject of intense debate, with some arguing about the benefits while others claim that the lenders are out to exploit users.
Someone somewhere sets up a company and then they give you a loan and then they list you in CRB. Mm-hmm. They ask us to fix those things. Mm-hmm. And they ask us also to ensure we cure these companies that show up from nowhere and then they give out money.
The app-based lenders have been around for more than half a decade, and while they've made millions of Kenyans get access to credit, they have also been accused of harassment of users in case of default.
I'm amending the Central Bank Act to enable anybody in Tala, anybody in Mshwari, to be regulated, to tell us what is the interest rate, to tell us where their offices, to tell us what are they doing, and then shaming and naming of individuals, and then protection of the data of those people who are applying these loans, because we want to have a safe environment for our young people.
And the banking sector regulator, the Central Bank of Kenya, admits that its regulatory framework is limited to traditional financial institutions such as banks, and as such does not have mechanism to regulate the lenders. Digital lenders have, however, seen themselves differently, arguing that they've provided Kenyans with more choices than ever before, although they face more risks when it comes to managing their financial lives. According to Dlak chairman Robert Masinde, the lenders have initiated conversation dubbed Moneymarch to bring providers and customers together to discuss how best they can leverage digital credit and other services to help customers and entrepreneurs grow and work towards their goals. Ivan Boa, Dlak board member and Tala Kenya general manager, while launching the initiative, expressed enthusiasm for the initiative, saying that they will support customers as they grow and work towards their goals. He said that providing customers with the financial education they need to make smart decisions is one of the many ways that they can deliver on that promise. Busana Naman for Ebru TV.